الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين، وعلى من سار على نهجه واتبع طريقته إلى يوم الدين، وبعد. The Quran and Prophet Muhammad's Sunnah are the constitution for every Muslim. In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the news of what happened before and what's going to happen in the future. Also, news about himself subhanahu wa ta'ala, his names, attributes, his promises, the things that he supported the prophets before with, and how he supported his prophets. Also, the Quran contains the code of conduct and how to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is a revelation from Allah, just like the Quran. And both the Quran and Sunnah work together. They are a revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Sunnah explains the Quran in every respect, in respect of creed, actions, statements, behavior, code of dress. So they are the constitution for every Muslim. Also, they are the final revelation from Allah. Being the final revelation from Allah sent to the final prophet and messenger from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indicate that this is it. This is the latest and final news from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every aspect of life and religion are discussed in the Quran and Sunnah, and how we should conduct ourselves with regards to the ideas, practices, the creeds that reside in the heart, statements, dealings, actions, acts of worship, and how to examine and analyze whatever issue that comes up in our life. These days, the issue of homosexuality has been discussed a lot. And there are Muslims who promote this aspect, homosexuality among Muslims. They promise to keep working among Muslims so that homosexuality is accepted, either as a civil right, because some of these people are saying that we can pass this homosexuality under the banner of civil rights in Islam, or other ways. And this has been pushed on Muslims in America and the West by the media, by corrupt people who want to replace the family and religion as the ones who teach their children their culture, their religion, behavior, aspects of life, aspects of religion, and replace family and religion with their agenda. So, بإذن الله عز وجل, this is the beginning, the introduction to a series of lectures and videos on the topic of homosexuality. We start with the top. What's the top for every Muslim? The Quran and Sunnah. بإذن الله عز وجل, in the coming videos, we will discuss something that should be basic. You see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about homosexuality in the Quran, told us about the story of his prophet Lut alayhi salam, what happened between him and his people, and told us their story. It seems to many Muslims that even though they pray behind imams, especially in Ramadan, where many masajid insist on reading the entire Quran during the month of Ramadan, 29, 30 nights, reading a juzu every night, which is not from the sunnah, by the way. The issues of homosexuality and homosexuals is mentioned repeatedly in the Quran. Do they pay attention? Are they asking, what does Allah say about this topic? Did he say anything about it? Yes, he said so many things about it in the Quran and in the sunnah of his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We have it. We read this ayat. Those who are Arab, who listen to the ayat or read the ayat, they understand more than the Muslims who don't have the opportunity to understand Arabic. Inshallah, they will. Because Arabic is their language. You know, those who say La ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah, Arabic is your language. It is yours. Don't worry about some Arabs who think that it's theirs and only theirs. No. Arabic is your treasure. It's your gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You can talk in your language. You can teach your language to your children. But Arabic is basic to understanding the religion that is Islam. And Islam, the meaning of it, one of the meanings of the word Islam, is submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What did Allah say about Qawm Lut? We will start this series of lectures in the Allah Azza wa Jal with statements from the Quran about this topic, followed by statements from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about this topic, followed by discussion of this issue with respect to politics. Muslims who try to push this aspect down the throat of all Muslims, especially children. We'll talk about it also from historical point of view, also from psychological point of view. So, bi-idhnillah, it will be a comprehensive discussion of this topic. And I'm hoping that Muslims, bi-idhnillah, who watch these videos, pay attention carefully to what the Lord has said in the Quran and by the words of his Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, knowing that one day we will meet Allah alone, and we have to prepare our defense of the way we lived our life. My name is Jalal Abu Rub. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed me to work on dozens of books with my family. By the blessing of Allah, translation and authoring of books reached 60 books so far. 8 books only last year, 2021. And tens of thousands of articles. Hundreds of trips to all kinds of Islamic institutions, centers, masajid in America and other countries. I had been calling to the Quran and Sunnah and the way of the companions publicly and strongly since 1984. And it is my duty, my pleasure, my honor to again come to the defense of the Quran and Sunnah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed me to translate a half of Tafsir Ibn Kathir. I'm working on Tafsir As-Sa'di, translating and editing the great book of Sirah, Zadul Ma'ad by Imam Ibn Qayyim Al-Jawziyyah, rahimahullah, and tens of other books, including Muhammad's Role in Islam, which talks about the pillars of Iman, the pillars of Islam, and how Allah protected the Quran and Sunnah from corruption. Please watch these videos. And today I'm going to mention the summary of the topic of the people of Lut and what happened between them and their prophet Lut alayhi salam, the summary, followed by a reading from the ayat of the Quran about this topic with explanation, بإذن الله عز وجل. So these are the ayat of the Quran. Sadly, I know that some Muslims don't know the extent of how the Quran and Sunnah explained this topic. So today is the summary of the topic. بإذن الله تعالى, next videos will continue as I explained. And بإذن الله عز وجل, we promise we will not allow the un-Islamic ideas and practices and agenda about this topic to be pushed on Muslims. We will not. Since 1984, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed me to visit so many masajid. This topic wasn't prominent in any way or form when we used to go to different masajid and Islamic centers. It has become as such in recent years. My name is Jalal Abu Rub again, and I promise you, we will stand behind our religion, our Quran, our Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, with full support and faith. And we apologize for nothing, nothing that came to us from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran or the Sunnah of His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. This is the first of the ayat of the Quran that we're going to discuss بإذن الله عز وجل. In Surah Al-Anbiya, which is Surah number 21, ayat, sentences 74-75. Ayah, by the way, in Arabic means sentence. Surah Al-Anbiya, Surah 21, ayah 74 and 75. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about Lut alayhi salam, an honorable prophet that Allah sent to a very difficult nation that was prominent in history by being the first to practice homosexuality. La ilaha illallah. Being first. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلُوطًا آتَيْنَاهُ حُكْمًا وَعِلْمًا وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْقَرْيَةِ الَّتِي كَانَتْ تَعْمَلُ الْخَبَائِثَ إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا قَوْمَ سَوْءٍ فَاسِقِينَ وَأَدْخَلْنَاهُ فِي رَحْمَتِنَا إِنَّهُ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Perfect words from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallah, perfect. In two sentences, we have the summary of the news of two opposing parties, Lut alayhi salam and his family who believed in him except his wife, and the city of Sodom, Sodom, wa Amura and Gomorrah, seven cities led by the city of Sodom, from which the word sodomy is used, still used, alhamdulillah, until today. So two different parties here, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala summarized their existence on this earth. And he knows his slave and servant, prophet and messenger Lut alayhi salam, and he knows Lut's people to whom he sent his prophet Lut alayhi salam, and the issues that Lut discussed with his people. Allah says, وَلُوطًا, and Lut, آتَيْنَاهُ حُكْمًا وَعِلْمًا, we gave him the ability to make decisions about different issues, issue judgment, حُكْمًا, حُكْم, judgment, وَعِلْمًا, and knowledge. So Lut عليه السلام, this is his description. He's one of our prophets. We believe in him. And look at the blessing Allah gave Lut alayhi salam. But his people didn't care. Who's Lut? Ataynahu. We gave him hukman, the ability to make decisions about different issues, disputes. Wa ilman, and knowledge in the commandment of Allah and in his sunnah, because every prophet was sent with his own sunnah also from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he had knowledge and the ability to issue decisions, hukum, about all kinds of opposing parties with regards to issues, people disputing with each other. Also, in the second ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the fate of Lut, وَأَدْخَلْنَاهُ فِي رَحْمَتِنَا, we entered him, we sent him, we covered him, فِي رَحْمَتِنَا, under our mercy. Lut alayhi salam, covered by Allah's mercy. إِنَّهُ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ, he is from the righteous ones. Wallah, description, honorable, blessed, from the one who knows everything and everyone. He knew what Lut was about because he gave him hukman, ilman, and salahan. He gave him hukum, the ability to make decisions, issue fatwa, and say things about, disputes between people, ideas, practices, even people, based on ilm, knowing Allah's revelation, knowing Allah's statements and decisions. And he himself was from as-salihin, among those who were righteous. Unbelievable description, wallah, honorable, blessed, Lut alayhi salam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلُوطًا آتَيْنَاهُ حُكْمًا وَعِلْمًا وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْقَرْيَةِ الَّتِي كَانَتْ تَعْمَلُ الْخَبَائِثِ. Now about his people, the قَوْمُ Lut, and we saved him from the village, Sodom, Sadum, from the village التي كانت تعمل الخبائث, that used to practice خبائث. خبائث, plural for خبيثة and خبيث, wicked, wicked things. The خبيث is a wicked person. The خبيث from actions and statements are خبائث. The devils are also called khaba'ith in the sunnah. La ilaha illallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and we saved him. Now this is the summary of his village. Min al-qaryati, from the village. Allati kanat ta'amalu al-khaba'ith, that used to practice al-khaba'ith, the awful sins. What is their value with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا قَوْمَ سَوْءٍ فَاسِقِينَ. They were, because of these khaba'ith, the awful sins they used to practice publicly, the wicked things they used to practice and say, إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا قَوْمَ سَوْءٍ. They were evil people. So, they are an evil people still today, even though they're not with us anymore. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا قَوْمَ سَوْءٍ فَاسِقِينَ. They were a people of سوء, evil, wickedness, فاسقين. And because of their evilness, they were فاسقين, meaning they deviated from the way of Allah, from the nature Allah created in human beings. It's Allah who makes the decisions about all issues. Ya Muslim, Ya Muslimah, listen to Allah. It is Allah who makes the decisions. It's not us, it's Him. And understand the value of Lut alayhi salam as compared to his people, and why his people were described like this in the Quran and by the words of our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even in the Bible talks in many ways similar to what the Quran and the Sunnah say about the people of Lut. So we want to talk about Qawm Lut in the Quran and the Sunnah, because there are warnings in the Quran about those who follow their way. A people who are described as ta'malul khaba'ith, innahum kanu qawma saw'in fasiqeen, we need to stay away from them and from their sin. Again, every one of us will go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Prepare your stance and for your stance with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Prepare your defense. The least you can say to Allah that the issue of homosexuality came during my lifetime and I supported your Quran and the Sunnah of your Prophet. I read your ayat about this topic and the ahadith that you revealed to our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam. I believed in all this. I did not in any way or form promote or became lenient or tolerant of these issues. I didn't. This is the defense you need to prepare with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the angels are recording for each one of us until that moment when we go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But in this life, I swear by Allah, we will push back, we will support our religion, we will defend our religion according to what Allah revealed in His Quran and what He revealed to His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in His Sunnah. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among the righteous, similar to Lut alayhi salam, when this issue and all other issues of kufr, shirk, fusuq, and asiyan come up, that we act like Lut alayhi salam and like Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam, all the prophets of Allah and the community of the believers from the time of Adam alayhi salam until the end of time. We ask Allah to be like them, among them, some of them, to be joined with them on the day we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala Muhammadin nabiyil ameen. Wa ala sahbihi wa azwajihi ajma'in. Wa ala man sara ala nahjihi. Wa taba'a siratahu wa sunnatahu wa tariqatahu wa hadiyahu ila yawmiddin. La ilaha.
وَلُوطًا آتَيْنَاهُ حُكْمًا وَعِلْمًا وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ ونجيناه من القرية التي كانت تعمل الخبائث إنهم كانوا قوم سوء فاسقين وأدخلناه في رحمتنا إنه من الصالحين